the Gandhigram Rural Institute, deemed to be university, celebrating its 69th Republic Day in the glorious campus. All the faculty members and students participated in the celebration. Dr. S. Nadarajan, Vice Chancellor of Gandhigram Rural Institute, hoisted the national flag and delivered the Republic Day address.
Good morning to all of you. Today we celebrate 69th Republic Day. My greetings to all the students, teachers, all employees of GRI and fellow citizens of India. Today GRI feels proud of our student, namely Ms. Kalaivani, second BCom Corporation, who is attending the 69th Republic Parade at New Delhi. We have to celebrate Republic Day in our country with pride and honor, because exactly on this date, in 1950, the Constitution of India came into effect, replacing the India Act 1935. Dr. Baba Ambedkar was the architect of this Constitution of India. Constitution of India is the governing document of India. It is the supreme law of India. It declares India as a sovereign, secular, socialist, and republic country. And all the citizens of India are equal before this constitution. No one should be discriminated by region, religion, caste, creed, and race. only fraternity should be developed in India. The Constitution also gives detailed duties, responsibilities, rights and functions of all Indian citizens, including President, Vice President, Prime Minister, Chief Ministers and elective representatives as well as common men. The first President of India, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, and the first Prime Minister of India, Mr. Jawaharlal Nehru, took their office after the Constitution was implemented in 1950. We have brought number of amendments now and then, depending upon the need base with the approval of Parliament. As on date, the entire India, the entire world look India as a shining star. Our Honorable Prime Minister is respected as one among the three top leaders in the world. We always maintain peace and friendship with our neighboring countries in the world, and we represent SAARC, G20 and ASEAN countries, and also participate in international forums like Indo-African Committee and World Economic Forum. Economically, every day we are becoming stronger and stronger. The IMF has forecasted that India will achieve the GDP by 7.4% in 2018 and 7.8% in 2019. Government of India has initiated more than 50 schemes or initiatives in order to provide employment for our younger generation. The schemes include Digital India, Startup India, and Make in India, and so on. So far, nearly 72 lakh youth have been employed in different schemes by the initiative taken by the Government of India. Nearly 82% of our people in India use internet facility right now. The country is advanced in science and technology. All of you may recall that on 12th January 2018, the country has launched the 100th rocket with a capacity load of 400 kg with 31 satellites. That is the first achievement our country has made ever. The vision of our Honorable Prime Minister is to create Team India with new innovation and technologies, because only by innovation and technology our country can move forward. So we have to create New India by the year 2022. The vision of New India has to be achieved by the implementation of programs related to agriculture and rural development, education and health, then employment, manufacturing and exports, urban development, infrastructure creativity, and macroeconomic balances. Government and government initiatives alone cannot make New India. All the citizens have to participate in making the New India with a new vision. Every citizen should think of more on duties than rights, as per the message passed on by our first Prime Minister as well as our first President of India in 1950. The country now deliberately needs political, economic, environmental and social security. All of us should contribute towards national building and national development process. We must think in every second of our life about the welfare of our nation and as well as the welfare of our institute. While celebrating the Republic Day, let us salute the national leaders of our freedom fighters. Let us also salute our brave soldiers who are fighting across the boundary of our nation. Let us salute and remember the glorious leaders who drafted the Constitution of India. Let us always think of national integration and love our fellow citizens of our country. நாடு முன்னேற நம் அனைவரும் அயராது உழைக்க வேண்டும். நவீன தொழில்நுட்பங்களை பயன்படுத்த வேண்டும். தீவிரவாதம் முற்றிலுமாக ஒழிக்கப்பட வேண்டும். சாதி சமுதாய வேறுபாடுகளை களைய வேண்டும். பருவநிலை மாற்றங்களால் ஏற்படும் சவால்களை சந்திக்க அதற்கு தகுந்தாற்போல் புதிய உத்திகளை கையாள வேண்டும். இவற்றையெல்லாம் நாம் அனைவரது ஒற்றுமையாலும் தன்னலமில்லாத அயராது உழைப்பினால்தான் சாத்தியமாக செய்ய முடியும். ஒன்றுபட்டு உழைப்போம், உயர்வோம். ஜெய்ஹிந்த்.
ಭಾರತ ಭಾಗ್ಯ ವಿದಾದ ಪಂಜಾಬ ಸಿಂಧು ಗುಜರಾತ ಮರಾಠ ದ್ರಾವಿಡ ಉತ್ಕಲ ಬಂಗಾ ವಿಂಧ್ಯ ಹಿಮಾಚಲ ಯಮುನಾ ಗಂಗಾ ಉಚ್ಚಲ ಜಯದಿ ತರಂಗ ತವ ಶುಭ ನಾಮೇ ಜಾಹೇ ತವ ಶುಭಾಶಿಷ ಮಾಹೇ ಗಾಯೇ ದವಶಯ ಗಾತಾ ಜನಹನ ಮಂಗಲದಾಯಕ ಜಯಗೇ ಭಾರತ ಭಾಗ್ಯ ವಿದಾದ ಜಯ ಹೇ